And the words, "You have cancer," not only affect an individual, but an entire family. Tonight, more than 300 people gathered to help raise money for a local support house. 4029's Damon Maloney joins us live with details on an annual fundraiser that keeps growing. Damon?
It sure does, Tiffany. Organizers of the Backyard Barbecue and Brew say with the down economy, they were expecting to see a dip in attendance. But this year's event drew more people than expected and more sponsorship dollars than last year, and will help hundreds of area residents battle cancer.
The Cancer Support House runs off of grants and donations from the community. So if we're not bringing in money, there is nowhere for the patients to go here. And
at this point, that's why event chairperson Casey Collier is pleased with the community support.
Tonight we're going to have a silent auction, a live auction, which is our first time ever at this event.
The big prize of the night is a trip to Las Vegas, but even more important is who benefits from all the festivities.
I'm a four-year breast cancer survivor. I was diagnosed at the age of 37.
Lori Robertson found her tumor after a self-exam and relied on family, friends, and the cancer support house during her road to recovery.
They provided wigs, turbans, and I know that they also provide gas cards, and in some cases they're able to provide financial assistance for prescription drugs.
The house also provides support groups, which Dr. Daniel Mackey says improves the quality of life for cancer patients.
You see other survivors, other people who had the diagnosis, gone through the treatments, and are actually survivors. I think that is a great motivation to stick with the treatments and just to live a normal life.
These types of fundraisers help make it possible to keep the lights on and to provide those services.
Now, Tiffany, the support house hoped to raise tens of thousands of dollars tonight. Tiffany, the nonprofit serves not only adults but children. Right now, several youngsters are using the services provided by the facility.
Okay, thanks, Damon. Most of the patients that use the cancer support home are recommended by their physicians.